Let's take a look at these images here. Nothing remarkable, right? Just a picture of a husky and a German shepherd, right? But what if I told you that there is neither a husky nor a German shepherd on the screen here? No, that's because that's actually an Alaskan Malamute and a Belgian Malinois that we see here. Well, it maybe takes an expert dog breeder to tell the subtle differences between all of these different dog breeds apart, right? But it gets interesting if I tell you that an artificial intelligence system can actually distinguish all of these different dog breeds with a very high accuracy. So, quite remarkable. Let's take a look at two other images here. Again, nothing really remarkable, just a person that basically indicates a stop command, right? And if we ask the AI system from before again, it will indeed say that the image on the left is a human that indicates a stop gesture or command. However, the image on the right, the AI now thinks that this is actually a completely opposite. Actually, the human's intention here is to come closer, to approach the human, which is potentially dangerous. So what is happening here? What we just witnessed here is a phenomenon known as adversarial attacks. Because if you take a closer look at these two images, we notice they're actually, in fact, identical, except to a small noise pattern that is added to the image on the left. And the magnitude of this noise pattern is so small that it's visually imperceivable for the human eye. However, the AI now thinks that this is something completely different. These phenomenons of adversarial attacks have been first discovered almost a decade ago on image classification neural networks. And it has been shown that most modern neural network architectures are actually susceptible to these kind of misclassifications. In particular, it has been repeated on voice recognition. You can even print out adversarial patches to fool object detection algorithms. And finally, researchers proposed 3D printed objects that are invisible for an AI in an autonomous vehicle, right? So you may argue that's actually a good thing that this adversarial attacks exists, because in case of a rogue artificial intelligence system, Terminator style, you can just print out adversarial patches and distribute them to disable the AI, right? But on a more serious side, it's actually problematic for safety critical applications, right? Because in safety critical applications, when we want to deploy AI systems, we require safety and security, right? And we see here a video of a Tesla that is unable to detect, for instance, the truck that fell over and crashes into that. And we want to avoid that. I want to make one clear distinction between that actually adversarial noise is not the same as random noise. Let me elaborate. So we know that an image is basically comprised of a set of pixels, right? And each individual pixel has a red, green, and blue color information corresponding to the light intensity of these wavelengths of light, right? And when we modify and add noise to an image, we have two possible options. The first option is random noise, where we basically flip a coin that tells us whether to increase or decrease the color channel of a certain pixel. Or we can do it in an adversarial fashion by actually taking a look into internals into the network and increasing or decreasing the intensity value of a pixel such that the prediction of the network moves towards a misclassification. And because we have so many pixels and repeat this process, we basically trigger a misclassification of the neural network. So let's visualize this. So here we have the image from before with different magnitude of random noise applied to the image. And if we ask the AI from before to classify these images, we'll see that it's actually quite robust. Up to the second most highest noise magnitude that we see here, the network has a 99% or 100% accuracy of classifying this thing correctly. And only at the very highest magnitude level, we see that the performance of the network degrades. But now, so as a result, this really shows us that neural networks are quite robust to random noise. But now let's replace the random noise with adversarial noise from before and repeat the same experiment. And what we see here is basically we see misclassification happening already at a very low noise magnitude level. So basically, the network can be fooled by perturbations that are invisible to the human eye. As a machine learning researcher, we then naturally ask the question, how can we defend ourselves, how can we defend the network against such attacks? So let's take a closer look at the training algorithm of a neural network. So for a training of a neural network, we need training data. For image classification, this is basically just images and the corresponding ground truth labels. So here, an image and the corresponding label stop. These two data points, this data point is then basically fed into a training algorithm that outputs a trained neural network that is then able to take the input as an image as an input and output a prediction of what is in the image. Researchers have then proposed a thing called adversarial training, which takes this algorithm and makes one minor modification to it. In particular, instead of just feeding the normal image into the training algorithm, each training sample is first attacked by an adversary. As a result, the neural network sees already adversarial attacks during its training process and is therefore able to adapt to these attacks. And the finally trained network is therefore robust against attacks. So everything's solved, right? We have adversarial attacks, but we know how to defend against these attacks. So done, right? Well, not so fast. Let's take a look at the CIFAR-10 dataset, for example, which is a standard dataset in machine learning research. So if you take a neural network and apply a standard training algorithm to this network, we can easily get an accuracy of 95% within a couple of minutes of training. But as I said before, because most neural networks are actually susceptible to adversarial attacks, this network will have almost no robustness. If we switch from the standard training to an adversarial training, we see a substantial increase in the robustness of the network from almost zero to around 61%, meaning that for 61% of the samples, the adversary was unable to find an attack. However, there's one downside. Because if you look at the standard accuracy of the network, we see a significant decrease from the 95% to 88%. As a result, when we want to deploy a neural network into a safety-critical domain, we're actually faced with a trade-off, with a question. Should we use the accurate network that's not robust, or the one that's slightly less accurate, but robust? And in my PhD thesis, we try to answer this question for autonomous driving, right? So what we took is an autonomous vehicle and an AI that trained to navigate this vehicle. And we applied standard training as well as adversarial training to make the AI robust to adversarial attacks. And we modified basically several strengths of adversarial training that was applied here. And what we see is that the networks trained with adversarial training actually crash the car and are unable to solve this task of driving the car safely. So counterintuitively, the network that's not robust to random, not to adversarial attacks, is the safest in practice. That's quite interesting. So what does it tell us? It tells us that the current adversarial training methods are insufficient to provide both the high accuracy and the robustness required for safety critical domain applications. And as we all just witnessed, and my job AI is becoming more and more researcher impacting working on this everyday lives forward, and a superpower really AI that is security, both accurate and robust
of such systems.
Thank you. And my job as a machine learning researcher is to continue working on this toward a superpower AI that is both accurate and robust. Thank you.